education system and in the future of our societies, and that is the skills connected with STEM, science, technology, engineering, mathematics subject. And thank you, Helen, for bringing a brief overview of
scientific research in the context of CIAS and STEM skills. Then it makes sense to think, to reflect on what is scientific proof. And before I played or became a grandmaster, I was actually working as a computer scientist. So I have a sort of natural sciences point of view. And there, you typically do some experiments, you develop a model that explains the physical phenomenon that you're trying to understand. And you sort of can get fairly concrete results. Of course, later down the line, you sort of push the border. So maybe like nowadays you have, for example, at CERN, some huge accelerators for particle physics. So it can be a challenge to get data, but this is the approach. If you are thinking about CIAS in the context of STEM skills, then we are dealing with sort of social sciences, and there are some challenges there. That similarly to CERN, there are some how you measure things, and also what you can measure. So I'm gonna talk a little bit about this. Well, I think since I am here, and you know, then we just go. So if we are thinking about CIAS in the context of STEM skills, then obviously we are talking about something called, near or far transfer. And in psychology, this means that we are training in one domain and we want to improve our performance in some other domain.
This would be the far transfer.
Well, also sort of near transfer.
Well,
STEM is, of course, a little bit broad spectrum. It's like science, technology, engineering, and math. And probably math is closer to CIAS than the others. But and actually, in this domain, similarly to the discussion before, the person was presenting on this statistical analysis and design of a big study that was carried out here in England. You have some different opinions and approaches, and so it's not like some math where you just have one answer. It's sort of open to interpretation. And some people say, like Melby, Levan, and Hulme, they were looking at working memory, that this is just impossible to achieve, but others are more optimistic. The important thing, that is that research on chess players, like top chess players or even grandmasters or international masters, there you will find some correlation between their level in chess and their sort of overall cognitive abilities. So you will find that they are above average in kind of a broad spectrum of cognitive abilities. For example, quantitative reasoning, or planning, or focused attention. Then the other three instead.